Cleanup is underway one day after lightning struck an apartment building and set it on fire. This happened around 5 o'clock yesterday here on Brockton Lane near the Watterson and Taylorsville Road. Gary Parker is there now with the latest for us. Gary, what can you tell us?
Eric, good afternoon. I mean, we often talk about the chances of getting struck by lightning, but much less about how having that lightning catch something on fire. But that was the case yesterday. If you can see right behind me, the aftermath of lightning striking this apartment complex. Now, people have been going in and out, just looking at the damage and taking things out. Now, property managers and residents are saying they are very thankful that nobody was hurt. And since nobody was home, this could have been a lot worse. Tenants assess the damage and move out belongings one day after lightning strikes and sparks this apartment on fire.
Just everything is pretty much trashed or it's kind of like it's ransacked, but everything is just completely damaged.
Fine says he's still shocked at what happened.
Really, no reaction, to be honest with you. I mean, I guess it didn't really sink in until I got here and saw everything.
James Daniels was on his way home from work when he heard the news.
You know, just what a roof was burning up, and it just, everything fell down inside.
The damage he has is not as bad as others.
Everything of mine ain't totally lost. My fish still living. Yeah, I just need to get the tank out of there.
There are some rafters, but most of them are charred. It's wide open on the top left. Lots of flood damage through the entire building. There's 17 units here. Everyone has extensive water damage. Smoke damage stays mostly for the top 12 units.
Property manager Brian Stocker has been helping tenants retrieve important belongings.
I would guess three-quarters of the value is gone. You've got a central boiler chiller system that may or may not be operational. It's very extensive.
An amount Stocker estimates for now is $500,000. Stocker says he's thankful nobody was hurt, much of which is owed to a small act of heroism.
It's my understanding that one of the tenants that lives in the unit that was struck ran through the building and told them fire, and helped get everybody out of the building.
Now, Stocker says that the Red Cross has already helped 7 of those affected tenants and will continue helping them until Sunday. Stocker says his company will also help all affected tenants find some new long-term housing. Reporting live, I'm Gary Parker, WLKY News.